we can do better than that. Let's give God some praise. Cause he's worthy to be praised. He's worthy to sound our praise because he's so worthy of his praise. Giving all praises to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To our pastor in his absence. Amen. To Reverend Chambers, Reverend Adams, Reverend Tate, Reverend Jones, my brother in the gospel, and to my father's children. It's once and again good to be in the land of the living. I'm always nervous when I step up here, so. Butterfly language. But it's good. Because God is good. They say they always save the best for last. I got to give thanks to my wife. She was gone all day yesterday. To give me time to prepare myself for this morning. I'm just glad that God brought her back home safe and sound, because she had the food in the back of her truck. I was really waiting on that. So. But God is still here. Y'all know me, I'm not going to hold you long, but I do have a word from the Lord. Reading from the English Standard Version. I'm reading from the New International Version. But first, I want somebody to read from the King James Version. As we stand, I need one person to read from the King James, and that is 2 Corinthians. The 4th chapter, the 8th and the 9th verse. Second Corinthians, the 4th chapter, the 8th and the 9th verse. Will somebody read from the King James Version?
We are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed.
Reads, we are afflicted in every way, but not crushed. Perplexed, but not driven to despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Struck down, but not destroyed. We are hard pressed on every side.
All right.
But not crushed, perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not abandoned. Struck down, but not destroyed.
All right. Amen.
I want to talk about don't give up.
All right. Amen. All right.
Turn to your neighbor and say, whatever you do, don't give up. Don't give up. We've come too far to turn back now. Whatever you do, don't give up. This is one of the letters Paul wrote to the church at Corinth and to believers throughout Acadia. Having founded the Corinthian church during his second missionary journey, Paul and the Corinthians kept in contact because of problems in the church. Paul encouraged those at Corinth to remain faithful to him as their spiritual father. He was always challenging and exposing false prophets who spoke against him and those who were undermining his authority and his apostleship. And you know, I like Paul for one thing.
Love me some Paul.
He didn't do, and that was he didn't give up.
All right.
As Christians, we are jars of clay. Like the Lord reminded Jeremiah, I am the potter.
Yeah.
You are the clay.
Yeah.
We at times experience sadness,
yeah,
tears, troubles, perplexities, weakness, and fears. But because of the heaven treasures in us, we are not defeated. Christianity is not the removal of weakness, nor is it merely the manifestation of divine power. But rather, it is the manifestation of divine power through human weakness. Mm-hmm. What I'm saying is, in all our afflictions,
yeah,
we are more than conquerors,
yeah,
by God's power and love.
Yeah.
And that our weakness, troubles, and sufferings open us up to Christ's abundant grace and allows his life to be revealed in our bodies. What I'm saying is, don't give up. When our outward circumstances become unbearable and your human resources are exhausted, God's resources are given to expand our faith, hope, and strength in him. God will never forsake us. Psalms 37, 25 says, I've never seen the righteous forsaken or his seed begging bread. Are you still asking yourself, is life really worth the living? Do you still feel like your back is against the wall? And you just either want to throw in the towel, I throw your hands in the air and say the heck with it all. Do you feel like running and hollering down the street, screaming at the top of your lungs, saying, I give up, I'm done, I'm through, you can have it, let me out of here, but I stopped by to tell you this morning, in the midst of it all, don't give up. But hold on. Don't give up. Mm-hmm. We may be pressed at every point, but not hemmed in.
Yeah.
There are all kinds of pressures, but we shouldn't be pressed out.
All right.
We are never in so tight of a corner that there is no way out. We are persecuted by men, but never abandoned by God.
Yeah.
We can be at our wit's end, but should never be at our hope's end. There are times when we don't know what to do. But even then, we should never doubt that something can be done.
All right.
There are times when we cannot tell or see where life is going. But rest assured that it is going somewhere.
Well,
we are sometimes knocked down, but we shouldn't be knocked out. Sometimes we're going to fall, but we will get up. The song says we fall down sometimes, but we get up. Let me stop here for just a second and say that Paul is a prime example of not to give up. He's been flogged and exposed to death. Five times he received 40 lashes from the Jews. Three times beaten with rods. One time pelted by stones. Three times shipwrecked. He spent a night and a day in the open sea. He even spent a night in jail, and most of the time he was in jail. He was in death. brothers, in danger from bandits, in danger from fellow Jews. He was in danger from Gentiles, in danger in his city. He was in danger in the country and in danger in the sea. But what you know I like the most about him then, he didn't give up. And my word to you is, whatever's going on in your world, don't give up. You know, we pray, we get stressed out taking Xanax and high blood pressure pills. And all you got to do is just try Jesus and hold on to life. And I guarantee you, he'll come through. Like Mark said, he'll show up and he will show out. We get all in a tizzy if we get a broke fingernail. We get all in a tizzy if somebody is talking about us. We get all in a tizzy if somebody look at us and even look at us cockeyed. We get all in a tizzy if somebody's talking about our clothes. We get all in a tizzy. But let me tell you something. All those are trivial things. Set your focus on Jesus Christ. Say, any man that says, seek ye first the kingdom of God. And my pastor this morning, and we was just reminiscing from the time we get sick. I said, look, man, look. I said, if anybody that you had scared was me.
Well.
I said, I think I even ran that red light and walked four road trying to get out of here to see you. I said, but let me tell you something. I've seen what God can do.
Come on.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Stand your ground. Take your time. And whatever you do, don't give up. And God is trying to tell somebody right now that people may be talking about you. People may be trying to dig ditches for you. People may be playing all kind of evenings at you. But guess what? Jesus still sits high and still lives low. I'm telling you this morning, don't give up. Well, as I move on and I'm just about done, Paul said that every time I go to do good, evil is present with me. Let me tell you something, folks. There are wolves dressed up in sheep's clothing, roaring like a lion, walking about seeing who we're thinking about. They don't care nothing about you. When you step out your door in the morning, turn around, look behind you, even look in front of you. But guess what? They ain't coming at you, buddy. What you do is be like, and dodge, throwing the fury darts at you. Duck and dodge, but whatever you do, don't give up.
All right.
Don't give up. And the reason I say don't give up is because we serve a God that's bigger than you and I. Paul said that he was, even though all the trials and tribulations that he went through, he leaves a prime example for us. He says we're troubled on every side.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yet we're not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. We are persecuted. But not forsaken.
Yeah.
He says we'll cast down, but not destroy.
Yeah.
My prayer for you, my Olivia, is that when you feel that you're in this type of situation, when you are troubled, don't give up.
Yeah.
When you are distressed, don't give up. When you are perplexed, don't give up. When you are persecuted, don't give up. When you feel like the world is against you, put some stride in your strut and some pep in your step and don't give up. When things go wrong But somebody said, hey,
thank you. praying church, and God is a prayer-hearing God, and He will answer your prayer. Sometimes He says yes. Sometimes He says no, not for you right now. Sometimes He says wait. But His yes and His no are as good as each other. Can't be God yet.
Thank you for the ones that gave. Lord, thank you for the ones that could not. In Jesus' name. Jesus Christ's name.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you for listening to me. As we start off the new year, whatever you do, don't give up. As you have Christ beside you, do not give up. People are just doing, taking their own life, and it's not that bad that Christ cannot help the situation. Remember that there is communion tonight.
Yep.
At 5 o'clock. The pastor expects us to do what we need to do, but God knows what we should do. So we'll see you at 5 o'clock. God bless you. Shall we stand?
I'm